NASCAR Live is presented by Nextel. Nextel, done.
The chase for the 2004 Nextel Cup continues, and it's happening now live at the Lowe's Motor Speedway at Concord, North Carolina, just north of Charlotte. Dale Earnhardt Jr. practicing on the racetrack. Elliott Sadler, other teams in the garage making adjustments in what is the first of two practice sessions here at Lowe's Motor Speedway for tomorrow night's UAW GM Quality 500. Yeah, go ahead, wave, show your signs. There we have it, a good crowd on hand for another and expanded edition of NASCAR Live. Larry McReynolds will join us in just a little bit. First order of business, the SpongeBob SquarePants 300 The Movie Busch Series race. Let's take a look at qualifying from last night. Greg Biffle, he has two Charlotte wins and six top tens in seven starts. He's led 361 laps. He will start third in that number 60 Ford. Robbie Gordon picked up his first Busch Series win at Richmond back in September. He's second, 181.910 miles per hour. Casey Mears in the 41 picks up his second pole of the year in that number 41 Dodge, the only driver to top 183 miles per hour. Let's take a look at your top 10 starters for tonight's race, which you can see on TNT. Jamie McMurray finished second in May. He got his only cup win here in October of 2002. Blake Feast making his second start in the double zero. Joe Nemechek, he's hot. He said here last night on NASCAR Live, he feels like he can sweep both races here. Points leader Martin Truex Jr. finished 14th here in May. You don't see Kyle Busch. He qualified 18th. He trails Martin Truex Jr. by 149 points. Well, as we said, practice underway for tomorrow night's Cup race, the fifth race in the chase for the Nextel Cup. Let's take a look at some practice highlights. First up, how about your points leader, Kurt Busch, fourth fastest in the 97. Busch has eight starts here, just one, or his best finish, rather, is 11th. Casey Kane in the number 9 Dodge, second quick in this practice this afternoon, looking for his first win of 2004. He's been second on five occasions this season. The fastest, Mark Martin, who made his announcement yesterday that next season will be his final full season in Nextel Cup racing. Mark currently fifth in the point standings. Jamie McMurray, we just talked about his only cup win coming here in this race 2 years ago, damage to that number 42 Dodge. He had been among the top 10 quickest in this practice. Let's take a look at how they stack up. There are your drivers in the chase for the cup. In yellow, Elliott Sadler, his only top five coming here in May. Jimmy Johnson, get this folks, has led 801 laps in his last five starts on this racetrack, including 334 back in May when he won the 600. Other chase drivers and how they stack up in this practice. Matt Kenseth, 21st, but that's an improvement because he will start 36th tomorrow night here under the lights at Lowe's Motor Speedway. So he said practice is underway. Bob Dillner down patrolling the garage area. What's going on, Bob?
Well, Steve, I got a question for you.
Yes, sir.
Would you pick Elliott Sadler to win the chase for the Nextel Cup? Putting you on the spot here.
I wouldn't bet against him. Everywhere we go, Bob, he gets better and better and has a career best finish.
That's right. As we mentioned last week, he moved up from 8th to 4th in the standings. But even though you may or may not have picked him, Steve, you know who did? This lady right here, Joyce Bertucci from Michigan. And she is this week's winner for the chase for the Nextel Cup sweepstakes for Nextel. And you've had a great weekend so far, Joyce. Tell me a little bit about what's been going on for you.
Well, we got to sit in on Elliott's press conference. We went down to the Nextel experience and got into one of those crazy cars. It's just been fabulous.
Why pick Elliott Sadler?
Well, actually, it was random.
Random? So you didn't even think he was going to win the championship? Let me in on the secret here.
I thought they all had a pretty good chance, really, but I did pick his name, and I'm glad I did.
So how did you determine to actually pick him? Did you just go eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch a tiger by the toe?
No, I had a little bit of help from my son.
Ah, so he's the guy with some wisdom, huh?
Yeah, right.
Very cool. Well, obviously, you're having a great time here. Is this like a dream come true? Have you been a racing fan for a long time?
Well, off and on through the years, through the kids, you know. But just the last couple of years, I've gotten into it rather seriously, so. But this has been a weekend from heaven. I mean, Nextel, I didn't think they could do anything this great.
Well, I'll tell you what, if Elliott Sadler wins the championship, she wins an awful lot of money. So Elliott Sadler, gonna put this dude on the spot right now. Are you gonna make her a lot of money or what?
I hope so. I told her that yesterday. It'd be cool if I win. We both get to make a lot of money. And I really wasn't nervous about the whole chase. So she actually came up, and I met her yesterday. She goes, you know what, I really need this money. It would change my lifestyle. I went, oh, God. You talking about putting the pressure on, but hopefully she'll be victorious at the end of the season as well as us. But it's a cool deal Nextel's doing and to get fans involved, and hopefully we can make her the lucky winner.
Real quickly, because we only got like 10 seconds, my producer Mark Smith says, come on, let's get okay. Cut to the chase. How's the car?
It's awesome.
One of the
best cars
I've
ever had here in Charlotte. We ran 20 laps, put on jack stands. We're going to run it 20 laps in next practice and put on jack stands, and hopefully they'll be chasing that combos car all night.
There you go. You love to hear that,
but
Stevie says
it.
It's awesome.
It's awesome. That's what we like. All right, Elliott Sadler, 143 points behind the leader, Kurt Busch. We'll take a break when we come back. Larry Mack joins us to talk about Lowe's Motor Speedway here in Charlotte. Kevin Harvick, sixth fastest in this first practice. First practice has just concluded of two here this afternoon, but you can see happy hour from the Lowe's Motor Speedway here in Charlotte, and that's next here on Speed. And welcome back to NASCAR Live. There's Larry McReynolds, people in the audience. Now's the time to wave. Wave. I've had to cue the fans out here, Larry Mack.
Well, they had a long trip from Kansas to here just to continue to follow me on my journey here in 2004.
And Canada, too. It's an election year. It says Canada votes yes for DW.
I'm trying to figure out what they're voting for DW, though. I'm not sure about that one.
We'll have to find out on trackside tonight.
That'll be a good idea. It'll be a good question to ask him. Hammond ask him.
We will. Hey, I want to cut to the chase and get to the chase, Larry Mack. Let's take
a
look.
No pun intended.
It's time for the fancy animation.
Oh boy. All right.
Okay, there it is. Larry's favorite.
I love that.
It's sweet, isn't it? Now let's get to the stats and take a look at the chase drivers, hear their performance at Lowe's Motor Speedway. Jeff Gordon, a four-time winner, as is Mark Martin.
And, I mean, Mark Martin has been phenomenal here. Remember that dominating win in May of 2002 in the Coca-Cola 600? But since then, he has bobbled. This maybe could be the place that Tony Stewart, Greg Zippidelli, and that group break out of that little box that they're in right now. They can't figure things out, but they are the defending champion of this race. And, of course, you know this is a racetrack that Earnhardt Jr., Jimmy Johnson, and Jeff Gordon are going to run good at.
So that's the performance of the chase drivers here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. Mark Martin has 39 starts here. Kurt Busch has just 8. Kurt's best finish here is 11th. But I want to ask you about Tony Stewart, because you and I were kicking that around. And you made a comment when the chase scenario was first announced I thought was good.
Yeah, back in January when they announced the chase for the championship, that they were going to take the top 10 drivers or anybody within 400 points, they were going to clunk them together and go at it for 10 races. I said, this has given that 20 team, the Home Depot team, a license to steal, because they are always so strong in the final part of the season. But 4 races into this chase, they only have, in those 4 races, they have 2 sixth-place finishes. And since they won at Watkins Glen, they have no top 5 finishes. And I talked to Greg Zippidelli the other night on a radio show, and of course this was his last win up there at the Watkins Glen back in August, and he says, Larry, we just don't know. We just cannot get a handle on it right now. But if you look across their garage in their shop, the 18 team, Bobby Labonte, they're almost in the same boat. So right now there's something missing at Joe Gibbs Racing with both those race teams.
Larry, I'm curious, Tony, his other win of 2004 was at Chicagoland, which everybody calls almost identical to Kansas where we just were, and he could just finish 14th as we see the stats there his last five races.
And he was never a factor at Kansas. And we know a lot of things have changed from last year, the tires, the aero, but he won the race at Chicago, and you certainly felt like that because they run the same tire even at Kansas, that he would be one of the stronger cars there, but realistically, he was never a factor.
Now, I want to ask you about the Lowe's Motor Speedway in the next segment, but in the remainder of this segment, I want to ask you about Jimmy Johnson. I did the math, as DW likes to say. He's led 801 laps here in the last five races.
Well, I couldn't think of a better place that that race team would want to come right now with the hole that they have been in over the last couple of months in the Lowe's Motor Speedway. I mean, I go back to the race here in May, the Coca-Cola 600, where this is a 400-lap race, 600 miles. Not only did he sit on the Bud pole, he led 500 miles of that race. In other words, it would be like leading every lap of the race here tomorrow night.
Yeah, and his four finishes in the chase, he was 11th at New Hampshire, 10th at Dover, 37th at Talladega, and then 32nd a week ago.
And I think the problem right now, he is well over 200 points behind our leader, Kurt Busch. As I've said, I keep using my word mulligans. I felt like coming into this chase, it was going to be borderline if you had one bad run. But now Jimmy Johnson and this 48 team, they've had two bad runs in a row. They are well over a full race behind Kurt Busch. So I think it's going to be a real stretch for those guys to get back into contention for this championship.
Take a look at his starts in the 500. This doesn't include, of course, the 600, but he's been good here in May and October.
And he's doing something here this weekend very unusual that he has not done a single other weekend over the last couple of years. He's actually running in the Busch race later on tonight. So Chad Knaus is going to be working with him as a crew chief in that Hendrick car, so they're going to learn a lot about this racetrack tonight, which I'm sure hopefully will help them.
Excellent. We'll have more with Larry Mack when NASCAR Live continues from the Lowe's Motor Speedway. They're cranked up for a big race weekend here. So is the King. We'll be right back.
My people. I love my people.
All weekend long.
The Hollywood sign is gone. It's just shredded.
A little bit of an altercation.
I should be used to you pushing me around.
Oh my God, I hope no one was in that car.
Banged up, battered, and bruised.
I didn't do anything.
What is going on out there?
You're not gonna make it! What are you thinking?
Depends on whether or not we're able to learn from our mistakes.
If we don't act now, it's going to be too late.
And the day after tomorrow, DVD is now available. And tomorrow, I'm curious about this racetrack because when we're here in May, Larry Mack, everybody says, boy, this is a temperamental place. It's weather sensitive. How will this racetrack be different tomorrow night or tonight even than it was in May?
Well, I think the difference is, for the most part, it's much cooler right now here in October. And instead of starting at 4:30 or 5 o'clock as the Coca-Cola 600 starts in May when it's very hot and the sun is beating down, this race starts about 7 or 7:15, so it's already starting to turn dark. It's going to be a rapidly changing racetrack. We're going to see that later on tonight in the Busch Series race. The more rubber gets laid on this racetrack, the more it changes, the more you have to keep up with changes. But you don't have to quite keep up with it as much as you do in the Coca-Cola 600, where you start in broad daylight and you end late at night. But just like right now, these guys were out there practicing from 4:30 to 5:15. I know exactly what was going on with those guys. Turn 3 and 4 was in the bright sunlight, getting a lot of sun on it. 1 and 2 is shaded, and I guarantee you most of these drivers were telling their crew chief, my car's a little tight. It's not wanting to turn down in 1 and 2, but it's a little bit loose getting into 3 and 4, and that crew chief has to be a salesman and say, look, driver, the sun's out. It's not going to be out tomorrow night. It's this next final practice that starts here in about 30 minutes that's really going to be the tell how your car is.
Larry Mack, of course, NASCAR is headquartered in Daytona Beach, Florida, but you know what? Over 90% of the Nextel Cup teams are located basically within a 30-mile radius of this racetrack. I mean, Hendrick Motorsports is a mile and a half that way, and, you know, Ganassi and MB2 just around the corner. This is an important home event for several reasons.
Well, it's a big weekend with six races to go in this chase for the championship. Other reasons besides the chase. One, it's the last Saturday night race of 2004, and I think everybody loves Saturday night racing, especially the teams, because it gives them an opportunity, as I used to say, we can live like a human being on Sunday. We can get up, we can go to church, we can have Sunday dinner, we can go over to Aunt Blanche's for the afternoon. Yep. We can live like a human for at least one day. But the biggest thing, you're right, Steve, 70 to 80% of the Nextel Cup teams, as well as the Busch Series teams, are from this area. Their wives, their girlfriends, their children, their moms, their dads, their friends are here. And I know the few races that I was part of winning here at Lowe's Motor Speedway, it was so neat because there's a lot of guys that work in the shop that they never go to the racetrack, but this is one of the races that they come to. And winning here and being able to have those teammates in your victory lane picture, that was always pretty neat.
Yeah, you know, I saw a sign. It says, Dale Jr. number 8 will get her done. That was a big weekend for them last weekend at Kansas City after all the adversity about his fine and his penalty for them to finish in the top 10 on that kind of a racetrack where they've struggled.
It was. I mean, that type of a racetrack, the mile and a half, 2 mile flatter racetracks with not a lot of banking. Let's go back to Las Vegas back in March. They were so bad. Finally, they said, let's park this thing. We're going to get run over out here. They changed the setup, but they just never latched onto it. They didn't run that good at Chicago. They didn't run that good at Michigan. The only flat racetrack that they ran well at was Indianapolis, and then they had the flat tire there on the very final lap. But I think those guys have learned some things by testing at Kentucky. They decided to use one of their tests and go to Kansas, and I said along, if those guys can come out of Kansas with a top 10 or 12 finish, I think they have made their mark as a contender for this championship.
Larry, I want to change subjects a little bit. It's been a busy week for news items. Jason Leffler was signed to drive for a third Joe Gibbs car with FedEx as a sponsorship. But it seems, Larry, like there's a huge changing of the guard all of a sudden. Mark Martin announced yesterday that next year will be his last full season. Rusty Wallace already has. Terry Labonte on Tuesday. And look at the numbers of those guys that are either going to step away completely or cut back their schedule.
I mean, just look at the number of wins right there. And, of course, you look at the championships there over in the right-hand column. But I think everybody is looking at that last name, and we're going to have him on trackside a little later tonight. Mark Martin, I think everyone would love to see that column over there that has that goose egg in it change to at least one title, because I think if anybody deserves to win a championship, it would be Mark Martin. But the neatest thing I see about those guys right there, I know Terry Labonte has not been to victory lane this year, is the fact that all of them are winners right now. Rusty Wallace won at Martinsville early in the year. Mark Martin won at Dover. Bill Elliott won at Rockingham the tail end of last year. So these guys, they're not just milking the end of their career. They're still out there. They're still contenders. They can still win a race on any given day.
All right, Larry Mack, appreciate the update. Go take a breather. Take Doodlebug back to the coach.
She's hungry.
That's his daughter. That's his daughter. And then get rested up for trackside.
Oh, I better get rested
Come
up
back
because, I mean,
peeps.
It is going to be a big show. And I know my people will bring their friends, and they'll bring their friends back to trackside.
That's a fact. Hey, watch this, Larry. Hey, fans, how would you like a 5% discount on NASCAR merchandise? I'll tell you how. Let's go shopping with Steve.
Get her done.
We're going to get her done. It's the chase for the Nextel Cup, and it's playoff time in baseball. Combine both looks with a NASCAR baseball jersey. Look at our models. You can find these products and much more at the NASCAR.com Superstore. Just shop and enter the code SPEED5 during the checkout process, and you'll get a 5% discount on your order. That's getting her done. Work continues in the garage, getting ready for happy hour. Meanwhile, don't forget the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series at the Texas Motor Speedway tomorrow afternoon at 2 p.m. as they continue their tight points battle. Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s crew parked next to Mark Martin. They're all making adjustments. Matt Kenseth's car in the foreground. Engine tuner at work. And we're getting tuned up out here at the speed stage. Just saw a fan from Wisconsin. The Cheeseheads are here as well. Represent. We go down to our Bob Dillner, who's in the garage. Bob, you're missing a good party out here again.
I know, but you never invite me out of there. You know, I mean, in the morning you invite me out for a little bit. When the people show up, you say, get the heck out of here, Bob. But I'm having fun down here in the garage area, actually sitting down like you right now with Mark Martin, who was fastest in that last practice session. A lot of focus on Mark Martin, of course, this weekend because he announced that he is going to be saying see you later to the Nextel Cup Series after next season. But let's talk about business. How good is that race car?
It's real good. We're just trying to get it, you know, fine-tuned for the 500 miles. The thing I like about it is it takes off as fast as anybody's, and that's always a good sign because our car usually hangs on better than most and stays longer. So we're real happy with it, but, you know, I'm looking to get it set up so that it'll be good for 500 miles.
I was going to say, of course, this is a nighttime race. You're practicing under the daylight here. How much does that make a difference, Mark?
Well, we don't have any other choice. It makes a little difference, but I guess you interpolate, I guess is the word. You know, you do the best you can with what you have to work with, and this is what we have to work with. And, you know, I've been doing this stuff for a while, and I can usually sense from practice a lot of the things that we're going to be needing for the race, and that's what we're looking for.
Of course, a big weekend for you with that announcement and so forth, and you've been interviewed by just about every single media member here. But tonight, Mark is on Trackside Live. Are you ready to get attacked by those guys?
Oh, I'm ready. I can handle those guys.
You hear that, Steve?
Oh, yeah. Mark's been on the show before. Hey, Bob, I'd like you to ask Mark. I kept hearing him use the word respect yesterday in the press conference, and I want to know the significance to him about that, what it exactly means to him.
Steve Burns and I were talking about this morning. In the press conference, you used the word respect a lot, and Steve wants to know, what does that mean exactly? What are you trying to reiterate there?
Well, everybody knows that respect, you know, means more to me than anything else. And 2005 and the Salute to You Tour is about giving respect to the people who helped me build my career, the fans, you guys, the media, the competitors, NASCAR, and everybody. That's what it's all about, is paying respect to the people that helped me build this career.
And we all know that Mark Martin has the respect of the Lowe's Motor Speedway. He has more top five finishes here than any other active Cup driver, and I believe that stands at 15, right, Steve?
15 top fives, 6 wins in the Busch Series, 4 wins in the Cup Series here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. Looking forward to seeing Mark at Trackside here at 7 p.m. on the stage. Thanks a lot, Bob Dillner. Well, we'll have more NASCAR Live just ahead. We're getting ready for happy hour here at Lowe's Motor Speedway, and you'll see that here on Speed. Mark Martin, 5th in points, heading into tomorrow night's race. NASCAR Live back with you from the Lowe's Motor Speedway. Race number 5 of 10 in the chase for the Nextel Cup. And we have people here from everywhere. They're celebrating their 35th anniversary. Congratulations. We will quickly get it down to Mr. Bob Dillner.
And we're walking along with Jamie McMurray, who just had some trouble in that previous practice session. Just tough break for you because that Texaco car was pretty darn good. What happened?
I guess the 99 car's rear end plug fell out or something like that. I don't know. We'd been tied all day pretty much off the corner and just got out from underneath me. And when I corrected, it was too much and ended up getting into the wall. So that's unfortunate. Same car that I ran fourth here with in the spring, and we've run well with it every weekend. But we unloaded a brand new car. It's we tested with it at Vegas about 40 laps, and it really wasn't that bad. We just had cars we thought were better that I was more comfortable in. So go out here and just see what we have.
See what happens. And this car actually, as he said, has been the backup car of all backup cars. It's been in the rig most of these intermediate tracks all year long, but has never gotten on the track other than a test session. Now, I will tell you, Steve, that the 99 team claims that rear end plug did not fall out on the racetrack and that Jamie might have hit somebody else's fluid, but they do actually confirm that the rear end plug for the 99 of Carl Edwards, when he came down on pit road, it fell out. NASCAR officials found it on pit road, gave it back to him. He left a trail of fluid all the way to his garage area. PK on the crew there stuck his finger in there, got the rear end plug and put her back in, and they're good to go for the next practice session.
All right, thanks a lot, Bob. We appreciate that. Of course, Carl will be in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series race tomorrow at Texas, if you can see that here on Speed. We're getting close to the NASCAR Busch Series race as Jamie Mack talks to Tony Glover, and Donnie Wingo.
NASCAR Live is presented by Nextel. Nextel, done.
Let's take a look at what's coming up on your racing menu tonight and tomorrow. Happy hour straight ahead, followed by Trackside at 7. We'll have more with Mark Martin. SpongeBob SquarePants Movie 300. He lives in Bikini Bottom. There's tomorrow's menu. Look at all the updates. Of course, the Truck Series race. Pitbull here at 6:30 live. And the UAW GM Quality 500 on NBC. NASCAR Live presented by Nextel. Done.